you hear? Are we clear? Clear for liftoff. Take off. For making reverberations. Are we affirmative? No negatory. Come in, come in. Radio, what's your story? Ayahuasca kilo. Will you welcome? Are you ready for a bit of Echo Victor? Feeling wider than awake. Yeah. Better quicken than straight.
Welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. MLB The Show has action out of the NL Central. It's the Milwaukee Brewers going up against the Pittsburgh Pirates. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set to go now. And today's starting pitcher, Roansy Contreras. Safe to say, he's pretty stingy, Chris.
Well, this guy's just been filthy out there on the mound. Hitters batting under 200 against him, and they're just having a hard time squaring up anything, doing any type of damage. The only way he hurts himself is if he gives up the free passes and surrenders a rare home run. But outside of that, it's going to be a tough job for the opposing lineup today.
Christian Yelich takes a strike as he leads things off.
7-0-5.
The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. Next offering is foul back. And here it comes. Now a screamer into the outfield. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Into second safely. It's a leadoff double to start the game.
Drove that ball nicely, put a great swing on it, and it jumped off his bat. Kind of put it all together there, and he's rewarded with the double.
Willy Adames stands in. In there for strike one.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
0-2 as he waves at that one.
Then he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
And the 0-2. That one drifts inside.
Looks like he was trying to get to the front door with that curveball. It's definitely a finesse pitch, but it backed up a little bit on him and stayed inside.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout. And there's one away.
Oh, really expanded the zone right there with that fastball off the outside corner of the plate. Got him to chase it. That's a tough one to lay off of because it starts close to you and just continues to run away from you in that batter's box. So it's a really nice pitch with two strikes.
Rowdy Tellez watches that one for a strike. Standing in here with one down.
He's going.
He's trying for third. Pitch is low. Throw safe.
When a guy's got that kind of lead at second base, somebody's got to call timeout. Pitcher's got to step off. The catcher's got to ask the ump for time or something. You can't let him get out that far. When you don't have a good thrower behind the plate, he's going to steal third almost standing up. That's a really good job of being aggressive by the base runner.
The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One away with a runner at third. And it's even up.
Well, he might have to look for a different put away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Next offering is downstairs. That one hooked foul.
Go back to Milwaukee.
The pitch. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Madris settles under this one and makes the grab. Runner tags from third. The throw's offline. He's saved. And it's 1-0.
Well, it's a nice job right there. It's always great when you can get on the scoreboard first. Just good situational hitting to bring him home from third right there.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it's Andrew McCutchen. And that's in there for strike one.
He didn't want to give up that run, but he did. Got the fly ball, sack fly out. Now it's time to attack these other guys. Get your team back in the dugout.
Two outs. And ball one. To the right side. Wide throw pulls him off the bag, and the inning still alive.
We all know that that first inning can be a critical one in terms of guys settling in and the tone being set for the game. So this isn't what you're looking for on defense. Two out errors are a lot like two out walks, but maybe even worse, because your pitcher did his job to get what should have been the last out of that inning.
Colton Wong takes a strike there as he stands at the plate now. McCutchen off of first with two away. Swing and a hard hit liner up the middle to base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Here's Luis Urias. That one fouled off.
Great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
Next pitch inside. Now 1-2. At the belt and fires. Ah, look out. That fastball drilled him. He had two strikes on him. And he hit him.
So that lack of execution puts a little pressure on the defense, too, to try to prevent another run. It's been a rough inning, and he's not instilling a lot of confidence on the mound right now.
Omar Narvaez in the box now takes a called strike. Bases loaded, two down. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Sawinski makes the catch, and that'll do it. On to the bottom of the first. It's the Brewers 1, and the Pirates coming up. We go to the bottom of the first. And towing the slab here, Corbin Burns. Last year's Cy Young Award winner in the National League, singing.
Well, Luke, he was healthy last year and gained a tremendous amount of confidence. He took a big step forward last season. I think he'll take another one this season.
Bottom of the first at the plate for Pittsburgh. Key Brian Haynes.
Key Brian.
The pitch. Upstairs. And the 1-0. And that one off the outside edge. That pitch gets the inside corner, and it's 2-1. And he deals. And he walked him.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick, great pass.
Ryan Reynolds here. Burns with a move to first. And he dives back in safely. In there, and it's 0-1.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup. With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Got him. Now one away.
Well, that curveball had some pretty good break to it. As you can see, the hitter just locked up a little bit. Thought it was a great pitch to hit, but sometimes you're looking for something else and you can't pull the trigger.
So next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Gly Madris, trying to pick up his first knock in the big leagues. First offering misses the mark. Check on the runner, and he dives back in safely. Next offering is down low. Two balls, no strikes. The pitch. A little bit low. And there's ball four.
Well, just came apart right there. Four pitch walk, and guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
So first and second with one man gone. Daniel Vogel back at the plate. First pitch, not close. Hayes on second. Madris at first. One gone. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. And they hold the runner at third, but the bases are loaded now with one out.
Batting fifth.
So bases loaded with one away. To the plate now for Pittsburgh is the DH, Hoy Park. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Oh, Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Going to count 1-2.
Well, Boog, early on in this one, having a hard time getting settled in. He's not showing control to throw strikes, and let alone to throw it where he wants in the strike zone. This could be a tough one for him.
Left hand batter waits. Got him! Huge strikeout there.
Well, they were pretty much giving it to him right there. Playing the infield back. All you're looking batting for on offense is a simple not ground ball. Stuff. You got a tie ball game. Not sure what he was thinking up there. Strikeout looking is the last thing you want to see. Now you got to hope the next guy can pick you up and come through with a big two out hit.
Here's O'Neill Cruz. Right side, hard hit. They take the force out, third out, and that ends the frame. Pirates leave them loaded, still behind by a count of 1-0. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's the second baseman, Keston Hira.
The second baseman, Keston Hira.
And the right-hander back to work. And first offering is fouled off.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Righty delivers. Out to short. Cruz on to first. And quickly one away in the second.
Batting none. The
you gotta be kidding me. Did you see that
Jonathan
throw?
Not really, Boog. Davis. I mean, it happened in the blink of an eye, it seemed, but thankfully StatCast is here to help us out. I mean, you don't see many throws across the infield that get up into the 90s, so he really reached back for that one, and he had to get the out.
Now batting Jonathan Davis. That hits the dirt. Ball one.
Ball one, no strike.
Oh, come on.
One down, base is empty. And there's a rocket into the outfield. And it kicks off the base of the wall. Around first, digging for two. And that's a double.
You got to get on your horse and get to that thing and get it back in because he's going to come barrel around first. He's going to put pressure on you. If you bobble it or you don't get there in a hurry, he's going to make you look silly and end up on second base.
So the lineup flips over. Now it's Christian Yelich. Doubled in his first AB. And it's fouled away. Now the 0-1. There's the strike.
Boog, one of our favorites. Jerry Hillsdale umpiring behind home plate in this one. Pretty much by the book with his strike zone.
And because he's so by the book, you'll sometimes see pitchers questioning him. They'll make a good pitch on the edge of the zone, want the strike, and not get the call. But most of the time, Jerry gets it right. He's a good one. Bounced up the middle. Sends it to Vogelback. Yelich out on the play. What about some no-nos? Like, you can't call the umpire blue the way you do in Little League or high school, right?
Yeah, even in the minor leagues, you'll learn quickly. You call the umpire blue. You better learn his name. And that's just part of being a professional player and even a major league player.
Willie Adames will hit next. His first at bat was a strikeout. Next pitch is popped up. Hayes gets under it, drops into the glove, and that will end the inning. After an inning and a half, it's 1-0. Back here in Pittsburgh, here's the center fielder, Jack Sawinski.
Leading off for the Pirates, the center fielder, Jack Sawinski.
And a pitch. Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. Jack Sawinski with his first major league home run, a special moment in his young career, and who knows, maybe that'll open the floodgates for him.
Yeah, getting that out of the way can be a big confidence booster. It feels like a huge weight has been taken off the bat. You can go up there with a lot less pressure on you now, and I wouldn't be surprised if he gets hot for a little while.
What do you remember about your first career homer, Chris?
Well, I remember it was off of Omar Olivares, and, you know, being there in Los Angeles against the Angels, just a tremendous day, great ballpark, and a special moment for sure.
So it's all tied up thanks to the home run. Michael Parrott.
Batting it.
The next Pirate to hit.
Michael.
That hits the dirt. Ball one.
Count 1-0.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
The 1-2. Just misses the mark outside the zone. Tied up here in the early going. Drilled in the air, right field, way back there, and that is out of here. That fires up the home crowd. His first homer of the year, it's 2-1.
This is the kind of thing that can really fire up the ball club.
Tucapita Marcano now at the plate.
Batting ninth, the left fielder, Tucapita.
Trying to bunt his way on.
Marcano.
And he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket.
Okay, from here, he's got to treat this as a clean inning. Forget about the fact that his team is now down by a run.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Next offering misses, and it's 1-2. And a pitch. Right through there, got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it. So the Pirates' batting order turns over. Key Brian Hayes, the next Pirate to hit.
Hayes.
Bounced out to short. On the run, throw to first. Two away.
Up next to the Pirates.
Seeing an impressive jump throw from the hole at short. Let's see what StatCast has to say.
Now he's just showing off out there. I mean, I don't know if fans realize how much arm strength you need to make that throw. This guy's got a rocket of an arm, and that was on full display right there. Just did an awesome job.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's a speed threat, Ryan Reynolds. In there for strike one. 0-2 as he waves at that one. Ground ball left side to first, and they take care of Reynolds for the out. Gets him easily, ends the inning. Top half of the third inning. Here's Rowdy Tellez.
Leading off for Milwaukee, the first baseman, Rowdy Tellez.
Contreras back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, the offense has gotten going, and a pitcher wants to go out there, have a real quick inning, get those guys back into the dugout so those bats can stay hot.
And down on strikes, and one away.
Gosh, here it is. Hit it. Three-pitch strikeout. All fastballs. Man, he's got a lot of confidence in that pitch right now.
Andrew McCutchen.
Here's Andrew McCutchen to hit. And the first offering is not close. Why to kick the pitch?
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
The wind to kick the 2-0. And a strike in there.
Cold night like tonight, last thing you want to do as a hitter is get jammed or even off the end. Trying to find that sweet spot on the bat. Tell you what, you're going to be trying to catch things out front, so off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
Crushed in the air. Left center field. Way back there. No doubt about it. Andrew McCutchen blasts one out. His first homer of the year, and we're level. It's 2-2.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So one out, nobody on. Colton Wong up to hit.
The third baseman, number 16, Colton.
Ripped into left center, base hit. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. One out, runner at second. Luis Urias digs in now. First offering misses badly for ball one. Next one misses 2-0.
Well, this is a little tough for the hitter in the back of the mind. You're wondering, with first base open, am I going to get a pitch to hit?
Oh, this one high and deep, way back there. And it's off the wall. The run comes in from second. It's 3-2.
stringing them together. That's three hits in a row. Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
Here's the Brewers catcher now, Omar Narvaez. 0 for 1. He was robbed of a hit on a diving catch his first time up. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Kicks and deals. Well struck left field. That one carrying. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases.
Four hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here. Anytime you can drive a ball into the gap the other way, it feels so good. And that's when you know you're right where you need to be at the plate. And it's even better when it gets you extra bases. Love looking in at your dugout and seeing the guys fired up.
Here's Castillera, grounded out to short in his first trip. First pitch just misses. One down, runners at second and third. And a ground ball to first. Slides, but he can't come up with it. The throw in. And he's in there as two runs score on the play.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Davis.
One down. Jonathan Davis, the next to hit. And that one gets away at the plate. And an excellent job keeping it right there. The 0-1. And strike two. Man at second. Tap back to the mound. Sends it to Vogelback. Out number two.
The batter, the left fielder, Christian Yelich.
Back to the top of the Milwaukee order. Christian Yelich up now for the Brewers. And that's in there for strike one.
When you're struggling out there on the mound, hitters know that there'll be plenty of opportunities within the at-bat to try to get something to hit hard.
Runner at third, two away. That's hard hit on the line. Drops in for a hit, couldn't run it down. In comes the runner from third, it's 6-2. The throw is wild and it gets away. In there, an RBI triple. A run comes in on the play.
Now batting.
Just a great approach. Looked like that was exactly what he wanted to do with that pitch. And right off the bat, he knew he was taking that wide turn at first to head for second.
Willie Adames up now for the Brewers. In there, and it's 0-1. Yelich at third with two away. Next pitch misses outside. And 1-1. Right-hander deals. That one missed.
Well, the good thing so far is that he hasn't issued any free passes. Unfortunately, they're making pretty good contact. So not getting the swings and misses. and making that defense work behind him.
And fouled off. And a pitch. And now it's filled up.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
And here's a 3-2. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. The pitch. Got him looking. That ends the frame. So 5 runs in the inning as they bat around. We move on to the bottom of inning number 3. It's the Brewers 6 and the Pirates 2. Set for the bottom of the 3rd, and now the right fielder, Bly Madris.
For the Pirates, the right fielder, Bly Madris.
And here it comes. That one missing inside.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Here comes a pitch. And misses inside.
And that's a pitch early in this game. He needs called for a strike. Struggling with command issues. He's got to get a little help from the umpire.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and that's strike 2. And the righty deals. And he chases that one. One away. And here's the first baseman, Daniel Vogelback. 1-for-1 with a single so far. Pitch misses inside, and that is ball 1. Left-hand hitter waits. Swung on, belted. That one back there, and it's out of here. Daniel Vogelback leads the yard. And they cut into the deficit. It's 6-3.
Well, he did a really nice job of letting that ball travel. Wasn't too quick. He kept the shoulder square to home plate, which allows you to drive the ball to the opposite field with power. You see the power and the authority, and fortunately, he's lucky enough to keep it fair.
Number 44.
Next to hit, Hoy Park. And there's a foul ball. The pitch. On the corner for a strike. The 0-2. Nope. And there's a ball. The 1-2. Bounce to the right side. Throw over to Telez, and they got him.
Now batting. Shortstop. Oh, yeah. Cruz.
2 outs, bases empty. Up next for the Pirates, O'Neal Cruz. That one's in there, 0-1. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Talk about tying a guy up. That was ugly.
Righty to the plate. Swung on. Popped up on the infield. Wong makes the catch, and that'll do it. But the Bucks get one back in the solo home run. And they've doubled up now. It's 6-3. Back here at PNC Park, and now it's Rowdy Tellez.
Leading off for the Brewers, the first baseman, Rowdy Tellez.
The wind of the pitch. This one popped up. Hayes settles under it, and there's one down.
The batter, the right fielder, Andrew McCutchen.
Andrew McCutchen up now for the Brewers. That hits the dirt. 1-0.
Count 1-0.
Kicks and fires. And that's in for a strike. That one is upstairs. Right-hander kicks, deals. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
They're
back in trouble, Boo. And it's just been like this for him most of the game. They've been all over him since his first pitch. And I think he's got a very short leash right now. Really needs to lock it down here.
Man at first with one gone. Next for the Brewers, Colton Wong. This one is smashed down the right field line. Way back there. Fair and gone. He'll touch them all, and they boost their lead. It's 8-3.
Love to see a hitter aggressive on the first pitch of an at-bat. You watch him from the on-deck circle, so when you step in the box, you're ready to pull the trigger wherever it's at. Really good job by the hitter. Total conviction on that swing.
Manager out of the dugout, and he's going to make a change. Roansy Contreras gives way. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. Pirates with a new arm on the mound, number 57, on for his major league debut. So we'll see if he's ready for the big stage.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And now Luis Urias.
Number two, designated hitter, Luis Urias.
Pitch misses inside, and it's 1-0. Just missed. Still only one out here in the inning. Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. The 2-1 is high. Pitch, and that's ball four.
Well, that's a really good take right there, and that's just mentally prepared, knowing that if it's not on a tee, you're going to take that pitch because you still have one more strike to work with. Not easy to lay off, but he did an excellent job in that plate appearance.
Narvaez stands in now and watches strike one. Urias, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Next pitch is inside, and that's ball one. In the air to left center. Sawinski racing over to make the catch.
Now batting, the second baseman, Keston.
Keston Hura up to hit now. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
All ones the count.
Two outs. And that's outside.
What was that?
Right-handed reliever. That one misses. And a count 2-1. A little out front there as he swings through it. At the belt and fires.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Kicks and deals. Line drive, and that's a base hitter to right. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
The center fielder, number
so
three,
two down, Jonathan Davis. Up now for the Brewers. And that's in there for strike one. First and second, two down. Out there to center, Sawinski settles underneath it. He makes the grab, and that's the inning. Two runs for Milwaukee on the dinger. It's now 8-3. Here at the ballpark, John Chavi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Jack Sawinski. The pitch. That's inside. There's a strike. Here's a high chopper. Gets it to first. And one gone to the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
The catcher number five, Michael.
Here's the catcher, Michael Perez. One for one so far today with a solo homer in his first at bat. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Hit on the ground to the right side, and it goes just foul. Here's a 1-2. Chop to third. Wong picks it up, gathers, and throws to first. Already two gone here in the home court.
Left fielder number 30,
two outs, bases empty. And here is Tucapita Marcano. Caught looking his first time up. First pitch, and he just misses. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Just missed.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Here's a 2-1. Just missed. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Burns keeping him close. Key Brian Hayes stands in with two away as he takes a ball. The 1-0. Marcano, the runner at first with two gone. Burns with a move to first. Marcano back in on a dive. And a pitch. And now 2-1. And he deals. Good eye in that spot. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
They just keep handing out gifts, Boo. Were we supposed to bring something?
The batter, see, I 10. Think just our presence is the present. At the plate for Pittsburgh, Brian Reynolds. First offering misses the mark.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
Next offering is down low.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
And a base hit. Marcano around third. The throw is offline and he's in to score. And it's 8-4.
Oh, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
So next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Bly Madris.
Now batting, the right fielder, Bly Madris.
Meanwhile, this pitch gets away. And now, a single might score two. And a 1-0. Swing and a ground ball off the middle. That's a base hit. One run is in. Now two runs score. And now just a two-run deficit. Bly Madris with his first major league hit, and this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. A guy works so hard and has to wait so long for this to happen, and when it does, it can kind of be overwhelming, dude. You still have to stay locked in on the game, but it's great when you can take a minute to just appreciate what you've done and how hard you worked to get here.
Here's Daniel Vogelback.
Now batting, number 19.
First pitch, not close. The 1-0. in there at the knees for a strike. Here's a 1-1. And that one almost got him. Burns with a move to first. Back standing. He's in there safely. Righty delivers. Next offering misses down and away. And the 3-1. And he grounds one to the right side. Tosses to first, and that ends the inning. We played four. It's the Brewers 8 and the Pirates 6. Welcome back. And now it's Christian Yelich.
Leading off for the Brewers, the left fielder, number 22, Christian Yelich.
With the right-hander back to work. Ball one, no strikes. Activity in the bullpen. Tyler Beattie appears to be getting loose. DeJong getting cranked up as well. Next pitch way upstairs.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. He's got to execute here or this could get ugly.
And the right-hander deals.
Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if he'll walk you.
Left-hand batter waits. And he takes a strike.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
The pitch. Ripped to short. Can't field it cleanly. Not in time. He legs it out.
Well, you have to take care of the baseball, and that's just not something they've been able to do in this one. That's their third error, and part of the reason they're losing right now.
Now it's the shortstop, Willie Adames. Pickoff move to first, back in there standing. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Count 1-0.
And the 1-0. Good eye right there.
Well, knowing that his hitter's got holes in his swing, because he's got so much power, pitcher still can get a little too tight, afraid to make a mistake.
That's towards center. Sawinski under this one. And there's one away.
Now batting, the first baseman, Rowdy.
Rowdy Tellez getting ready to hit.
Come on, you can do it, Pirates. Let's go.
And the first offering is not close. Yelich, the base runner at first with one out. Next offering is in for a strike. So now 1-2.
I got to count 1-2.
Next pitch is outside. Ah! righty to the plate. And that just misses. And he walked him.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches. And somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
And that one hit to first. Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. Throw is offline, and he scores. It's 9-6.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Wong now in the box comes up empty with a swing there.
Come on, Pirate, you can do it.
And the 0-1. And the pitch is outside. Ball one. One out. Runners at first and second. On the ground right side. 4-6. Three, it's a double play, and that'll do it for the inning. Well, they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's now a 9-6 ball game. We head to the bottom of the fifth. To the plate now for Pittsburgh is the DH, Hoy Park.
The designated hitter, Hoy Park.
And the pitch. Inside, just missed. And here comes that one to first. Tellez takes it to the bag, and a quick out number one.
Now batting, shortstop. Oh yeah, Cruz.
So up next, O'Neal Cruz. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. Back there, turning, looking, and that one is gone. His first homer of the year, and they cut into the lead. It's 9-7.
Oh, that one got the jet stream on a line drive. Saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame.
Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move for the bullpen. That's it for Corbin Burns, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. Yandel Gustave takes over on the mound, and he'll work on holding this lead.
Yandel Gustave.
And now the center fielder, Jack Sawinski.
Up next for Pittsburgh, the center fielder, Jack.
And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch misses way outside. Activity in the bullpen for the Brewers. Brad Boxberger, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Suter, the lefty, warming up as well.
Ball
next pitch is downstairs. On a line out towards center. He can't get there. That should be extra bases. And now it rolls all the way to the wall. Sawinski into second, and he's got a double.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. Put a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Now the catcher up to hit, Michael Perez.
Now batting, the catcher.
First offering misses badly for ball one. Tying run at the plate. On the ground, right side. Hero with the throw to first. And there are two outs.
Deceptive slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel a long time. Got that hitter out front. Rolled over it. Put it on the ground.
Number 30. Yucapita. Mark Otto.
And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder. Yucapita Marcano. He's 0 for 1.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
First offering, and it just misses. Sawinski on third with two out. Next offering is downstairs. And the righty deals. Swings through that one for strike one.
This guy's sink has so much drop in it. It's almost like a split finger fastball. Instead of just weak contact and balls on the ground, he gets swings and misses.
Throw over to Tellez. That's the third out. Bucks draw a bit closer on this long ball. It's now 9-7. And welcome back. And now the DH, Luis Urias.
Leading off for the Brewers, the designated hitter, Luis Urias.
And the pitch. There's a strike.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Will Crow loosening up in case he's called upon by Derek Shelton. And a foul ball left side. And a swing and a miss, and one gone. Omar Narvaez at the plate.
Omar Narvaez.
Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball one. Kicks and fires. That one drifts inside. Right-hander kicks, deals. Pitch misses. 3-0. And there's ball four.
Definitely lost the handle during that sequence. Four pitches for the walk, and that last one didn't even threaten the zone. Catcher might want to go talk to him.
So digging in, Keston Hira.
He's going.
Runner takes off the other way, takes it in for the out. Takes it to the bag himself and doubles him off. Top of the order, due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Brewers 9 and the Pirates 7. Well, we go bottom six, and now the Pirates leadoff man, Keith Ryan Hayes.
Leading up for the Pirates, the third baseman, Keith Ryan Hayes.
Gustave back to work. In the air, right field. McCutcheon settles underneath it, makes the grab, one away.
Up next for the Pirates, the second baseman, Ryan.
Up next for the Pirates, Ryan Reynolds. You tell me what's so good about being on. First offering way inside, almost got him. And a pitch. And another ball. Here comes a pitch. And that one sliced foul. The 2-1. And that's in for a strike. Here's a 2-2. Just off the inside edge. And now filled up. The pitch. Out towards right center field. Davis has this one sized up. Snags it for the second out.
The right fielder, number 14. Juan Madrid.
Two outs, bases empty. At the plate for Pittsburgh, Bly Madris. Smoked to the left, base hit.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Now here is Daniel Vogelbach. Way inside, and that hit him. Coy Park, the next Pirate to hit.
Designated hitter, Coy Park.
First pitch, and he just misses. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Brent Suter getting ready to go. Boxberger warming up as well. Left-hand hitter waits. Rolled to Rowdy. Fires over to first, and that is the inning. Pirates strand a couple. They still trail by a couple. It's 9-7. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Will Crow. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. We go to the top of the seventh. Here's the center fielder, Jonathan Davis.
The center fielder.
The wind and the pitch.
Davis.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Next pitch is outside.
If you're the pitcher, you've got to go right at this guy. It's the number 9 hitter in the lineup. You can't be afraid of contact in this situation.
Puts it in the air out towards left center. One up, one down.
The left fielder, number 22, Christian Yelich.
Here's Yelich at the dish. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Right
Next one off the plate inside.
Yeah, that's ball two.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. The wide to kick the pitch. Just off the outside part of the plate.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Kicks and deals. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second, and it bangs up against the wall. Round second, digging for third. Cruz with a relay throw. Not in time. He's safe. So one gone with a runner at third. Now the number two hitter, Willie Adames. Popped in the air, left field. Marcano makes the play. Runner tags for home. Throw home, not in time. The run scores. And they're up by three.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Two outs, bases empty. Rowdy Tellez up now for the Brewers. In there, and it's 0-1. The pitch. Had a good eye there.
Is there a little wrinkle to that?
I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
The 1-1. Yeah, there's the strike. The 1-2. That's down and in. The wind of the pitch. Stays alive. Two down, nobody on. And down on strikes he goes, and the inning is over. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. It's the Brewers 10 and the Pirates 7.
For the Pirates, the shortstop, Oniel.
And a pitch. Oh, now this is blasted. Way back there, on its way. Gone. He rockets one to right. He's done it again. His second homer of the game. It's 10-8.
Swing right there on that breaking ball away. Did an incredible job of keeping the hands back, letting it travel. And boy, he just hammered that. Recognized the break. And man, this guy kept his front foot down. Weight didn't transfer until the exact time. An excellent backspin to carry it over the fence.
New pitcher coming on, the veteran, Brent Suter. Trying to protect this lead. So up next, Jack Sawinski.
Now batting, the center fielder.
Swings through that one, 0-1.
Suwinski.
Yo, one. Ball one there. The pitch. off the plate inside, and the count is 3-1. And he couldn't come up with it.
Well, that'll bring the tying run to the plate, so all eyes on the man coming to the dish right now.
Here's the Pirates catcher now, Michael Perry. This one high in the air to left center. Oh, he can't bring it in. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Now the left fielder, Tucapita Marcano. Sawinski, the lead runner at second. Perez out at first with nobody out. Trying to move the runners over. Goes to second. Safe there. So Brad Boxberger rolls into the game, and he's being asked to clean up a mess with the bases loaded. So the batting order turns over. Now batting Key Brian Hayes.
Don't be surprised to ball on the ground to the corners if they come home with the baseball instead of going to first base. Well, this is a tough situation with the bases loaded, but the healthiest mindset is just try to get out one hitter at a time.
The possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Nobody out. Next pitch inside. Now 1-2.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
The pitch. Just off the outside edge. 2-2. So the tying run at second. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Bases loaded. Nobody out. And that one ripped into right, and that's going to be a double, and it'll score two. Two runs are in. Cut off, now a throw home. The tag out. But two runs come in on the play.
Well, these guys were trying to take the lead late in this ball game. It looked like he had a real chance to get in there safely, but the defense was all over it. Close play at the plate. The tag gets him just in time to keep the game tied.
Ryan Reynolds now at the plate.
The batter, number 10, second baseman.
First offering, misses the ball. On the ground. Over to first. And they take care of Reynolds for the out.
The right fielder, number 14.
Fly Madris, the next Pirate to hit.
Well, he came up clutch earlier in this ball game and really just needs to take the same approach. Think hard right back up the middle.
First pitch, just misses.
Let's go,
Righty delivers. Pitch misses. Ball two.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
Two down. Go ahead, run in scoring position. Next pitch misses, and that's ball three.
I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
Real down. And that one is in for a strike. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Squeezes it, and that will end the inning. Eighth inning coming up. We're all even at 10 apiece. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Chase DeYoung. This is his first appearance of the season.
DeYoung.
Ready to begin the eighth. Up now for Milwaukee, Andrew McCutchen.
Now this guy, a player that if he gets on base has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
And a pitch. And that's outside. And he deals. Smoked on the ground a second. Sends it to Vogelback. And that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
Third baseman, number 16, Colton Wong.
Next for Milwaukee, Colton Wong.
Oh, yeah, Boog. He's on the brink of one of your favorite milestones. He's completed three legs of the cycle.
I love me some cycle. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Bullpen action for the Pirates. Josh Van Meter up and throwing. The 1-0. And a foul ball. Here's a 1-1. High chopper to third. Hayes picks it up. And that quickly, two away.
The batter, the designated hitter, Luis Urias.
Luis Urias up now for the Brewers. Pitch misses inside, ball one. Next offering is in for a strike. Ripped on a line to center. Sawinski makes the catch, and that'll do it. Nobody left for Milwaukee. Our score holds 10 apiece.
So I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Do you think that's just a statement? Then you ludicrous like it's word of mouth. I ain't new to what.
Bobby Milner comes on now. Hasn't pitched in a while. He's had the last 5 days off.
Bobby Milner.
That back here in Pittsburgh. And now the first baseman, Daniel Vogelbach.
Leading off for the Pirates, the first baseman, number 19.
And the pitch. Called strike right there. The next offering misses. And now it's even, one and one. To the right side. One up, one down.
The batter, number 44. Designated hitter, Hoy Park.
The next Pirate to hit. Up the middle. Into the outfield, base hit. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Now back. A shortstop.
Oh, yeah. Drew.
Cruz in the box now. Takes strike one.
Always tough to turn two on a speedster like this. It's even harder with him coming out of the left-handed batter's box. You really need something to hit hard on the ground that they can handle to turn two quickly.
Throw to first. Next offering is in for a strike.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get in the scoring position.
And here it comes. Into center. Davis moving back for this one. He gets there to make the play. A nice running grab. And there's two away.
Now batting. Center fielder.
Jack Sawinski digs in now.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. And what you tell yourself is that I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
That one's in there, 0-1. Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. Strike in there. Throw to second and great jump.
When your catcher's not a great throw, you have to do a better job of controlling the running game. And that's throwing over, that's stepping off, doing whatever you can to try to keep that base stealer's rhythm off. Well, they weren't able to do it right there. They're going to have to make some type of adjustment or guys are going to be running all game.
Next pitch is outside.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
The 1-2. Got him looking. That's the third out. Inning over.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
Back here at the ballpark, and the batter now, Omar Narvaez.
Leading off for Milwaukee, the catcher, Omar Narvaez.
The right-hander back to work. And that's in for a strike. Good eye right there. And it is 2-1.
Count is 2-1.
Left-hand batter waits. And that skips into dirt.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
And the righty deals. Popped up. Cruz moving under it. Makes the grab, and there's one down.
Up next for Milwaukee, the second baseman, Keston Hiura.
Next for the Brewers, Keston Hiura. In there for strike one.
Well, we call that keyhole. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Next offering misses, and it's 1-1. And the right-hander deals. He swings and fouls one off. Right-handed reliever. Ripped on the ground a second. Sends it to Vogel back. Two up, two down.
The center fielder, Jonathan Davis.
Jonathan Davis up now for the Brewers. And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Next offering upstairs. Next one misses. And it's 2-1. At the belt and fires. Up the middle. Throws to first. And Milwaukee is set down in order. 8-9-1, two up in the bottom of inning number 9. We're all even at 10 apiece. Welcome back. Bottom nine at the plate for Pittsburgh. Michael Parrish.
For the Pirates.
A little surprised. They don't see a pinch hitter here with the lefty-lefty matchup.
Milner back to work. A little bit low.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
Hit to right center. And it hits the base of the wall. Hiura relay to second. He is safe.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask. Winning run in scoring position now, so a clutch AB could end this one.
Runner in scoring position, no outs. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Tucapita Marcano.
Tucapita.
That one hit to right. McCutchen should have this one. Puts the squeeze on that one. And there's one away.
The third baseman, number 13, Keith Ryan.
Back to the top of the lineup. And here is Keith Ryan Hayes.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Well, I say it's the best pitch in baseball. Strike one. You get ahead on a good hitter as well. He's a little bit more confident to move to the at-bat.
Winning run stands at second. Next offering is down low. And it's second. On a line. Opposite way with that one, and the Pirates walk it off.
Getting a walk-off homer is the kind of thing you dream about growing up. You're in the backyard, you're creating the most pressure-packed scenario, and what do? You come through with the big swing. Well, he was living a childhood moment right there. Nice swing of the bat, nice win for the team.
And your final, 12-10. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Chum. Talk to you soon.
Joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.